Once you have a good grasp of search engine optimization, SEO, you're ready to optimize your website. We're going to take you through the process step by step. You'll learn to develop, prioritize, and adjust your plan to suit your goals. But first, let's see how important having a good SEO plan has been for Mike's hot air balloon business.
What I've learned over the year which I've been trading is to really pin down and to come up with a more structured plan. It means I'm able to target and focus and put my efforts in a much more concentrated and effective way that delivers better results. Things like, I didn't know before that Google filters words. So misspelling of words, variances on words or themes. I can cut down on a lot of that chatter, if you like, or that wasted effort. And I'm also using things like maps to target localized business which I want to try and attract. I've really been able to see the benefits. You know, for example, my listing has improved on the organic Google sites. And of course, because I'm meeting the passengers, I'm meeting my customers, I'm able to get that direct feedback from them.
Let's say you want to reach new customers for your fresh from the farm fruit and veg online delivery service. Your first step should be keyword research. That means finding out what your potential customers are searching for. Are they looking for organic produce, weekly fresh vegetable deliveries? By the way, if you want to learn more about keyword research, check out our lesson about choosing keywords to focus on. Next, consider related topics. Are vegetarian diets popular? Do requests for gazpacho recipes come up? This will help you make your keywords more specific and a better match to what your customers are looking for. You should do this at least once a year as part of your SEO plan. Once you've identified good keywords, take a look at how you're doing in search results for those words. How many of these words and phrases bring up your website on a search engine? Are there specific topics that don't bring much traffic to your site? This info will help you figure out what's working for you and what's not. If a popular phrase like fresh farm vegetables isn't pointing customers to your site, you can address those missing pieces in your SEO plan. Once you've discovered the gaps in your SEO performance, your next step is to think about how to fix them. Maybe none of the content on your site mentions that you can arrange regular seasonal deliveries. Is no one linking to your site? Perhaps you can invite food bloggers to check out your farm in a hope that they'll mention you in a future blog post. Make a list of anything you think might improve your SEO performance. Okay, so now you have quite a to-do list. But don't worry, it's just time to prioritise. It's natural to want to tackle the items that will give you the biggest bang first, but be realistic. Adding an entire section about sustainable farming methods to your site might require hiring a programmer to help, which might cost a fair bit. In the short term, you could post a quick article about the topic on your blog. The next step? Give yourself a deadline for each task, so you're working through your SEO plan steadily throughout the year. Okay, once you've set this plan in motion, don't just forget about it. Your SEO plan will change over time. But how do you know when it needs updating? Well, one easy way is to check in when you're making other changes to your business, like introducing a new product or redesigning your website. Also remember that search engines release new features and improve their algorithms. For example, many have made adjustments because so many people now search on mobiles. Finally, adjust your plan when something isn't working. Is there a web page that's not getting much organic traffic? It may need a refresher. Are you attracting visitors to your site but not making sales? Or perhaps you need stronger calls to action? Review your results regularly and shift focus to the areas that need help. And that's how you build an SEO plan. Let's recap. Start with keyword research to understand what your customers are looking for. Then use that info to assess your successes and failures. Brainstorm solutions to improve your weak spots and prioritize them. And never be afraid to redo your SEO plan based on changes in your world and the world of search engines. Be sure to check out our lesson explaining the SEO process that has more helpful information to get your plan in motion.